Hi everyone, I'm Ritvika Roy. I'm a neuroscientist working in India. I'll be interviewing a few doctors who are working as frontliners currently.
It's actually quite physically and mentally exhausting and emotionally draining to see so many deaths because I am an ENT surgeon and I have never in my life seen so many deaths in such a short span of time.
It's actually like I feel like I'm living in the apocalypse. So it's very gloomy. It's very gloomy and disheartening.
Right.
You feel helpless.
And to see young patients as young as me, as my parents, to die in front of our eyes and we are like practically helpless. We can't help them because the disease is very severe this time. And this second wave has taken each of us by shock.
काफी प्रेशर है वैसे तो. पेशेंट ज्यादा है हमारे पास, बेड्स कम है, ऑक्सीजन खत्म हो गया था लास्ट मंथ. इंडिया में ऑक्सीजन का शॉर्टेज था और फिर आईसीयू बेड्स अवेलेबल नहीं थे. काफी प्रॉब्लम था.
एंड वी एज फ्रंटलाइनर्स आर ट्राइंग टू डू आवर बेस्ट टू हेल्प एज मेनी पेशेंट्स एज पॉसिबल, बट वी आर शॉर्ट इन टर्म्स ऑफ रिसोर्सेज, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, मेडिसिन, ऑक्सीजन. There are a lot of things that are holding us back. We are not able to give our 100% even if we want to because we don't have enough resources. The current thing which we need is oxygen, which is quite short in our supply.
And since we are facing acute shortage of oxygen, we don't have a steady oxygen supply. There's gross shortage of oxygen, so if we get help in that respect, that would be great. That would be very great.
So even though I think the government is trying its best to do whatever it can, it's still not enough because of the sheer number of patients we are dealing with daily, and almost each of them have oxygen requirement, much more than what was expected. But we are also having some shortage in vaccines as well.
We hope that this video will bring about a sense of awareness and more people will come up front and raise their hands to support India in its time of need. Thank you.